they are hard to slow down as well. So a new set of problems. And so I really think of more so as just, well, how good are they? You know, how much talent, how much skill do they have? But, you know, it may help a little bit that you see quite a bit of zone read, but I think that it doesn't slow them down at all. Those guys still operate at a high, high level.
I know everything evolves and the defenses match the offenses and then the offenses and the defense. I mean, it's a constant kind of cat and mouse game. Do you think that the offenses will eventually kind of evolve or devolve back into the maybe more of that power load at times?
Yeah, I think you might see some more power teams, but I don't think you're going to see a ton because, you know, what I think is different is the athletic running quarterbacks. There's a lot of those guys out there. I mean, that's what a lot of the high schools are doing. And you spread them out and put such tremendous stress on the defense. You know, the NFL is a different game. You know, they cannot get that guy dinged at all. And so they'll dabble in it. You see some of the teams that are very, very cautious, very smart. It's not going to be their whole system by any stretch. But I think everything's cyclical, but I don't see it like going back to the old days of you might have some teams that, you know, kind of gravitate to a Stanford style, and that'll be, you know, unique to them.
Chris, your defense has been exemplary all year long. How do you think they played the other night?
I thought they played like they kind of normally do. I thought they played real hard. I thought they played physical. It is the physical offense. I think, again, what hurts the defense tremendously is we don't create a lot of offense. You know, I think that puts a lot of pressure. I think the game, the momentum, the energy changes when you do some things on offense. And we just didn't even have the ball much. So I think that really stresses them against a good offense. You know, they empower you from 5 yards, 5 yards, 4 yards. And they got a nice play action game off it. And they do enough to, you know, move McCaffrey around. You know, I thought they did. I thought they battled hard. I thought they battled all game long. But you know, when you're not creating a ton of offense, it puts stress on the defense as well.
How much more will they have to prepare for with two styles of quarterbacks, Rams and Strickland?
Well, yeah, he runs the ball more than the other guy, but their style is what it is. I mean, they're a running offense. Solomon, I mean, he runs the ball as well. He's his own read quarterback. So it's not like they're deviating tremendously from what they do. And they have more designed runs for him, quarterback draws, those type of things, he can scramble. But they're not creating a new offense for him.
With Miles, the way he's running, do you have to fight sometimes, the tendency to just feed him the ball more like 38 times instead of 18?
You definitely need to get him the ball. You know, he's proven and he's making plays for us without question. But we also need to have some balance to our offense to be able to get the passing and going. I mean, I think that's the rub. That's the interesting part of things. And so, yeah, he keeps moving the chains for us a little bit. But, you know, they're just going to keep packing the box and making it a little bit ridiculous if we don't get some things going in the pass game. We should need to be able to get some explosive things going, which have been minimal for us.
Did Stanford try to do that in the second half? Did they change the